name's Philip Beasley, and I'm a professor of architecture here at the University of Waterloo. This project is called Hylozoic Ground. Hylozoic is a lovely ancient word, which means life out of material, and that principle of working closely with concrete material qualities in meticulous, delicate, fragile ways forms a kind of guiding principle for this work.
Hylozoic Ground is an immersive, interactive architectural environment. It's a combination of experimental architecture, distributed electronics, and distributed sensing that creates an environment that people wander around in, and they get immersed in this sort of question about what is the future of architecture and what would it be like if buildings could feel us and breathe and sense that we were there.
This work asks some fundamental questions. Can architecture immerse and surround us? Can a lightweight architecture start to respond to us? Might architecture in certain ways come alive and show the ability to live and breathe? Might it even know and care about us? We're drawing on mechatronics, lightweight structures, next generation design and computation, and increasingly living chemistry as well, regenerative chemistry, in order to make a kind of metabolism, a whole network of many layers of material that make a near-living architecture. This kind of work is a speculation, a hope for where architecture can move in the future. The work of responsive architecture is receiving quite a lot of attention in manufacturing. I mean, for example, automated solar shades that track the sun, perhaps that even generate electricity, is an example of the formidable economic benefit that can come from responsive architecture. There's also environmental processing, such as carbon-eating paint, such as a kind of metabolism that can run through the surface of the buildings that offers immediate possibility for ways of building architecture in the future. There are several different disciplines at work: lightweight structures, next generation computation, living chemistries, communication systems, mechanisms, graphics, writing, critical research, and each one of those plays a fundamental part that's woven together in a many, many layered system. This work is fundamentally a collaboration drawn from the climate of Waterloo.